गुड इवनिंग सर।
दिस कॉल इज नाउ बीइंग रिकॉर्डेड।
या नाउ टुडे वी विल गो फॉर अ स्मॉल टॉपिक कॉल्ड स्टोरेज क्लासेस। वी विल वाइंड अप दैट एंड द नेक्स्ट क्लास ऑनवर्ड्स वी विल स्टार्ट वन ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स कॉल्ड अरेज, व्हिच एक्चुअली कवर्स इन मेनी प्रोग्राम्स व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू डू इन फ्यूचर। ओके, नॉट ओनली हियर, आई मीन वी टॉक अबाउट कोड बीटा लाइक प्रोग्राम्स, देयर आल्सो इन मेनी केसेस वी हैव टू टेक द अरेज एंड वी यूजिंग दैट अरेज वी हैव टू डू प्रोग्रामिंग, राइट? आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स, दोज हु आर स्टिल एनरोल्ड, दे शुड अटेंड दैट क्लास, एंड द ईसी एंड ट्रिपल ई स्टूडेंट्स वी कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन दैट अरेज कॉन्सेप्ट। वील स्पेंड मोर टाइम इफ यू वॉन्ट, वील गो इन स्लो, ओके, वील प्रैक्टिस मोर क्वेश्चन ऑन दैट, मोर प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन दैट. So that's what your future plan. But anyhow, today we'll wind up that the last topic of what's the functions related concept called storage classes. And these storage classes always we club with the functions, because when we talk about the function, we know it is a separate block actually. So from one block to the other block, when the control is moving, then what type of behavior that a variable is going to show or going to express is what we are going to discuss as a part of the storage classes. Okay. So that's what about today's class, and if time permits, anybody want that? What about the assignment, Amma? I told you to submit the assignment. Only two girls have submitted. I don't know about other people what they are doing. May I know that why the other people have not submitted the assignment which I have given? Yes, Amma. Variable number of arguments function upon which I have asked about to do some program of writing the printf, your own printf function you have to create. And should exactly behave like as your printf function how it actually behaves. So in response I got only two answers from two girls. What about other Sama? Yes, I want at least you speak someone, Amma. Most many of them are there in the class, no one will speak, only few people respond. Yeah, Deepthi Reddy. Yeah, Deepthi Reddy, are you there in the class? G Deepthi Reddy, Guna Deepthi Reddy, yeah, hello, yeah, Deepthi Reddy, Akhila. जी अखिला,
यस सर, गुड
आर यू
इवनिंग
देयर?
सर,
गुड इवनिंग
यस
अम्मा.
सर,
लक्ष्मी देवी,
यस सर,
जी मधु, मधुलिका जी, जी मधुलिका, आर यू देयर इन द क्लास? See, if you people, I don't know that whether they are listening in the class or not. And what about this Manasa Gaud? Manasa Gaud?
Yes, sir.
Good, Amma. You listen the class, Amma. Monica, are you listening? CAC Monica. K Monica. CR. CAC.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, Amma. Okay. So all of you, I'll test randomly like this. In future classes, because let me know that whether you people are listening or not, because the second time when you attended your WhatsApp test actually, which is conducted by or given by the different faculty, I mean their marks are deteriorated. So I want this should not take place again. Okay, whenever you are attending that, everybody should get at least above 80. Particularly, I'm interested in EC and triple E, because all these CSE people, they know very well about all these concepts which I'm telling. Just for them it is a revision, and of course they can go in depth, and for that it is benefit for me as well as for them also, but I am interested in EC and triple E students. So today in any case I'll bring the list of all that EC triple E students, those who are there are part of this particular course, and randomly I will call, and if I won't get respond I'll simply inform the same status to the coordinators. Okay, let them take the action. Anyhow, let us start our today's concept. As I told you, that storage classes. So what the storage class actually tells is, it tells about the future of a particular variable, how it is going to behave. If you have declared a particular variable in a block or in a function, like as a main, then what actually the function is going to show its features, in what type of features that a particular variable will hold. Okay, so that's what indicates or indicated by the storage class. And these particular features about the storage class related to a particular variable are basically, we express them, these features, we express them in four ways. One is we talk about the scope of a particular variable. Say, for example, we have declared a variable in main, say int a, a is a variable of integer type, you have declared it. What is the scope? Where you can use that particular one? Up to what extent it is visible? The scope tells about the visibility. That's what one feature that we have to talk. Second feature is lifetime. Okay, up to what extent the memory is available which is allocated to that particular variable. Okay, that we talk about, what's a lifetime. Through that we talk about the lifetime. And what is the initial value? Suppose sometimes, you know, even if you won't declare or you won't define it, some initial value will be stored in that. So what type of initial value a particular variable is going to hold based on the storage class which is assigned to it. And last but not least, the storage. You know, when you talk about the memory map, can anybody tell me just roughly, so at the time of I think pointers and all, I told you that memory map of a particular variable. Do you remember that how memory actually related to a variable is allocated? Overall memory in RAM. Yes, anybody, Amma? At the bottom, you'll have text place, text or code place, code memory. Whatever that code you have retained, whatever that you have compiled it, the object code is going to dump there in the bottom of that particular stack, that we call it as a text memory or code memory. And code memory is always attached with what, sir? Static memory. Ledamma, code memory along with static memory together is stored at the bottom of that particular stack. Okay. Upon that, upon the top of that, what is there, sir? Your honor, the heap any? Yeah. So if you see that memory.
Yes, sir.
Heap. So, okay, some people say that heap after the above of what's a static memory you'll find. And then above heap, you'll have what's a one more memory stack also there. What it is? So, thus, the overall memory which is allotted to a particular program can be imagined in four different partitions. The memory is partitioned related to a program. Memory is partitioned into four slots or four, what's that, stack elements. At the bottom, here, this, if you imagine that it is allotted to a particular program, then at the bottom you'll have code-related memory. So this is fixed memory. Okay, it will not increase, not even decrease. So here is a place where your object code is going to store, is going to load. Upon this top of the code memory or text memory, we have what's a static memory. So here I told you that in the static memory, you'll have all the variables which are declared as static as well as global variables. So global and static variables are going to be stored here in this memory. And above this, we'll have stack memory. Okay. You can even sometimes consider as heap memory also. And above this, we have heap memory. So in between heap and stack memory, some place will be there, because whenever stack memory increases, it takes this additional space which is empty. Similarly, whenever a heap memory is there, which is increasing, then that heap memory also will take the additional memory from this particular empty. Okay. So thus, the stack and heap memories are not fixed. They are fluctuated based on the number of variables you are taking, based on the number of allocations you are doing dynamically. The space increases or decreases. Okay. So that's what about the overall frame, memory frame related to a particular program. So if you remember this, these are the three places which are important for us where the variables are going to be stored. One is static, second one is stack, and the third one is heap memory. I told you about the heap memory. Heap memory is used, okay, for the variables which are dynamically allocated. Dynamically means through memory management functions, when we dynamically, when the runtime, when we are allocating the memory based on our usage, that particular memory is taken from heap. And stack memory, I told you that whenever your functions are called, function related, all the local variables and their local return values, all stuff will be stored as a part of the stack here. And static memory is also a memory meant for variables to store. And here in the static memory, you'll have all static variables which are declared, and all global variables are going to be stored in static memory. So the static memory and core memory are fixed in size, and the stack and heap memories are fluctuated always. So that's what the memory map. And if I recall that memory map, related to that memory, here we talk about the storage, where the store, where the particular variable is going to store. Is that variable which is declared is going to store in the stack memory or in the static memory, or is that going to store in heap memory? Where, in which particular place of your memory these variables are going to be created is what we are going to discuss as a part of the storage. So these are the four important features that changes from one particular storage class variable to other storage class variable. So that is what the four important features which we are to discuss today. And how many storage classes are there in C then? Okay, fine. Up to now, we didn't use any storage class, but knowing unknowingly, one of the storage classes already, okay, we used till now, in almost all the programs, we use one of the storage class variables, that is automatic storage class. But apart from that particular storage class variable, we have other types of variables also, which we can change their storage class property. So thus, in C language, there are four storage classes are there, which are attached with the variable. One is automatic. The second one is external storage class, extern, the keyword extern we have to use. Third one is static storage class. And to declare the static storage class related variable, we have to use a keyword called static. And lastly, we have register. So these are the four storage classes: automatic, external, static, and register. External means we should not call it in completely. Simply the keyword extern, if you use, it is quite enough. Similarly, for automatic, no need to use complete spelling called automatic. We have to use a keyword called auto. So these are the four storage classes. And using these four storage classes, when we bind, when we attach with a particular variable, their features in four directions will get changed. And that four features which we are going to discuss are scope, lifetime, initial value, and where the variable is going to store, that is storage. So let us start with the first one called automatic storage class. So this automatic storage class is a default storage class, because if you want to declare any explicit storage class to a particular variable, then that variable is by default treated as an automatic storage class variable. And related to this automatic storage class variable, okay, if you are not declaring with the keyword called automatic, it will treat, okay, default, it will take it as an automatic, or otherwise explicitly we can use the keyword called auto. Okay, and the important property about the automatic variable is automatic variables can be only accessed within the block or function. Okay, and once if you come out of the block or function, the memory which is allotted to the variable related to automatic type are simply erased. That is what about the automatic variable. Okay. So let us see that four properties or four features related to the automatic storage class variable. The scope is what? Scope is nothing but it tells about the visibility. It tells the scope means scope of a particular variable related to a particular storage class means it tells about the visibility of that particular variable, whether that variable is visible, can we use that particular variable in that particular block or not, is what the scope tells. So scope related to automatic variable is limited to the block only. That means in whichever the block you have declared your variable, in that block only it is, okay, visible. And once if you come out of the block, it will not be available. The visibility will be erased, or visibility will be gone. That's what the important property related to the scope of automatic variable. And the default value in most of the compilers, the default value for the automatic variable is garbage. That means if you won't store any value, it will take some random value. So it will take some garbage value and will assign to that particular variable if you won't initialize. In case if you have initialized, then whatever the value that you have taken as an initial value will be taken, okay, and will be stored in that memory. So thus, the default value for automatic variable is always garbage. Okay, default means if you won't store anything, if you simply declare the variable. So let me tell again, the declaration and just definition. The difference is here, suppose if I say simply int a then it is simply declaration. We haven't stored any value. But along with that declaration, if you suppose store some value, it is what definition. So by default, here in this case, it is always treated as automatic, because for automatic variable, no need to use any keyword auto. If you won't use, it will take by default as automatic variable. So this A is a automatic type variable. And this automatic type variable, the initial value, we haven't given anything. We haven't stored any value as an initial value to A. So thus A may have any garbage value. It will have garbage value. But some compilers, they take that automatic variable value, garbage value, instead of garbage value, it will take the initial value as zero. Like as your the GCC compiler, if you run, the automatic type variable will hold initial value as zero. So that's what about that. Other than that, most of the compilers, they take the automatic type variable initial value as a garbage value. And then come to the lifetime is, once the control goes out of the block, the access simply will be destroyed. That means the memory which is created to that particular variable simply will be destroyed. So that means the lifetime is when the control is within the block, okay, and up to that time only the memory is allocated, the memory is available. And once we come out of the block, the memory which is allocated to that particular variable of automatic type will be destroyed. And last but not least, the last feature is storage place, where such type of variables are going to be stored. We discussed already at the time of what, sir, call by value, call by reference, that these automatic type storage class variables are always stored in the stack memory. Okay, within the RAM only, of course, they are all. So stack memory, we have to remember. And how to declare, I told you that the declaration part, when it comes, no need to use the keyword called auto, or otherwise explicitly, if you want to use, you can use it as auto into some variable or auto data type some variable name. Otherwise, even if you won't provide any storage class keyword, then by default it treats that it is automatic type. So let us demonstrate about these properties one by one through some example. So let me go for this particular example here. I want to demonstrate about the automatic type. And here I'm taking only main. And within main only, I'll try to show the blocks as structure, how multiple blocks can be created. So here, int, a variable I've taken called A, and storing in that 10. And here, one more block is created, internal block. And in this internal block also, I'll create a variable, say B, which holds say 20. And third block also I'm going to create, say int, there also I'll take integer variable only, C, which is having some 30 in that. So likewise, main block is there, and second the sub block is there, and the third sub block is there. So three blocks are created. And here that A is a variable which is declared in the main block, okay, and B is internal block, and C is a complete internal block variable. So these are the three variables with different names are declared at different blocks. Now what I'll do, I'll try to access all the three. Let me see what the problem that I'm going to face here. Say A is equal to percentile D, comma B is equal to percentile D, comma C is equal to percentile D. And I'm printing A, comma B, comma C, hoping that all are accessible. Hoping that all are accessed. That means I can access all A, B, C's. So now once again, after coming out of this most internal block, second internal block, let me write one more printf statement. The same I will type. Okay, I'll copy and paste here. And here, let me see the visibility of it as well as the lifetime. Then in the third place also the same, I'll try to print. So what I'm doing here, I have created three different blocks. And in each block, I have declared a particular variable of automatic. See, I told you I didn't use any keyword here. And if you are not using any keyword, by default, the compiler will treat that the variables of respective data type are always of which type? Automatic type. So right now for me, A, B, C, all are automatic type. Only difference is that these A, B, C's have taken it in different blocks or declared it in different blocks. Can anybody tell me what the output you are going to get? Yes, Amma. Anyone? Okay. As the explanation which I made about the automatic storage class variable, if you want, I'll revise it. The scope of the automatic variable is local to the block where it is declared. Suppose if certain block in which you have declared a particular variable means in that block only it is visible. And once if you come out of that block, that variable is no more visible. So that's what about the scope. Come to the lifetime here, the same like as a visibility, lifetime is also whenever your control is in particular block in which whatever the variables are declared, that variables within that block you can use. And if you come out of that block, the variables will not be used. I mean, we cannot access that particular variables because the memory is destroyed. And thirdly, the storage, all these automatic type of storage variables are stored in stack memory. So all these ABCs are stored in stack. And lastly, what it is, sir? Default value. Of course, here we provided the values for all the ABCs, and here we are running in this GCC compiler. So even if you won't provide, all the values will be zero. But I want that explicit values to be passed. That's why I passed 10, 20, 30 respectively in ABC three different variables. So tell me, anyone, what is the output? Yes, Amma, anyone?
Sir, in first printf, AB values will be garbage values or zero, and C value will be 30.
Okay.
Second, in the second printf, B value will be printed as 20.
So that means,
and other will be garbage.
Okay, so that means you are able to access all the three. You are seeing that only, na? Garbage, let them be garbage, but even if they are garbages, you are able to access it because you are printing. You are able to print the garbage values, means you are able to access them. Right now, you won't get any garbage. But actually, we have provided some values for A, B, C's, though they are declared in different blocks. But we have provided 10 for A, 20 for B, and 30 for C. So actually, either you have to get every 10 or sir, A, B, C means what? 10, 20, 30 to be displayed in all the three cases, because I didn't provide, I didn't keep empty. I provided the values to the respective variables. So any other answers, Amma? Yes, Amma, any other answers?
Sir, for the first statement, it will be saying that A and B are undeclared.
Okay.
Only C.
So what is the output you are going to get? Are you going to get any error or you are going to get some output?
Error, sir.
Error. Good. What type of error, Amma? Just roughly
undeclared,
tell me.
Sir.
Okay.
Those are undeclared ones.
Yeah. So let us compile this. Observe carefully. Fatal error. STDIO. I think STDIO spelling is there. So this error is not important for us. So typographic mistake. Observe that. I'm finding an error here at the second printf, stating that C undeclared at the line number 11, the second printf. I'm finding some error stating that C is undefined, because you, once if you come out of the internal, now where that C is declared, am I, anybody tell me? Most internal block where C is declared. Agree? Here is the place where the C is declared. Now you are coming out of this particular block.
Internal block, sir.
Yes, Amma. And your control, once if you come out of this internal block, I told you that this is no more visible. This C, which is declared most internally, is no more visible. Okay, so the visibility is gone. Because as per the automatic is concerned, the visibility is local. Within block only, it is visible. That variable is visible. Similarly, lifetime is also same, local to the block. So thus, because of, once if we come out of this internal block, C, you cannot access it. The variable C, one cannot access because it is an automatic type. That is why it is showing that C is undeclared. And of course, for the second printf, the two are global. So therefore, B is local, A and is global, both are visible. They are visible. But when it comes to the C here, C cannot be used in the second printf because you came out of that particular block. Okay, the block we came out. As a result of that, C is gone. The visibility of C is gone. Life is also gone. So So C is no more available for the second printf. That's why it is shown as error. Now similarly, the 13th place also, that is third printf statement, here also it is showing error, stating that B is undeclared. Not only C, but here at the third printf, when it comes for the third printf, only A is visible. B and C are no more visible to the third printf. So it is showing that B undeclared there. Are you getting my point, sir? All of you? Are you getting all of you? So B and C are no more available for third printf statement. So that is what the important thing. And same through the simple example, be able to understand the scope as well as lifetime. Okay.
Sir, for third printf, A is also not available now, sir. Visible now, sir.
Which one? A.
For third printf.
Third printf, which is not visible?
A is also not visible now, sir.
Let me tell you, if I remove this, your timing I'll remove. Otherwise I'll shade that one. That in two internal blocks I'll shade. If you want more clear understanding, if you want, what I'll do, I'll remove timing. I removed it. The two internal blocks which I prepared are completely removed. Now can't you say that A is available for third printf? Just concentrate on it, because that's what. So let me undo it. So I reprinted it. Okay, observe careful that A is global to the internal two blocks. Remember, A is global variable to these two internal blocks. So A is always available for all the three printf statements. For the second printf statement, this one, I'm interested on line 11. Okay, for this particular one, okay, B is local variable. Otherwise, what I'll do this time, I'll remove this here. So this second printf, for this B is local and A is global. Global is always global. It is accessed from anywhere. So therefore, both A and B are available for this second printf, but C is not available. Okay, so again, I'll do undo. And coming to the third printf, just now after removing the two internal blocks, so what I found is that A is completely available, but B, C are not available because B, C are local to their respective blocks. And once we come out of that respective blocks, it is no way visible. That means B and C are no way available. So that's what about the problem here. Now, what I will do, I'll slightly change the program. Instead of taking them with the three different variable names, I have given the three different variables with the same name. The most external global variable declared as A having 10. Second internal block variable is also declared as A having 20. And third one is also declared as A and having 30 in it. Now tell me, is there any problem? First of all, the question is, can you declare a variable like this having same name in a same program?
No, sir.
Yes. No, sir.
Two different conflicting answers, sir. I got.
Overloading.
Yeah, actually it is possible because block wise, even function is also treated as a block. We have seen, we can declare the local variables or parameter, formal parameters and actual parameters, we can give same name. There is no conflict there because the memories which are going to be allocated are completely different. So therefore, first question, the answer is yes, sir, we can declare the variables in the same program, provided that they should be declared at different blocks. That's what here I'm demonstrating. I've declared all the three variables with the same name, but they are not declared in the same block. Rather, they are declared in different blocks. So therefore, the different memories are going to be allocated for all the three different A's, and all three A's are treated differently. So there is no error chance you are going to get. Now, what about the second one? Second type of doubt. Are they available? Now what I'll do, naturally, instead of printing ABCs, because I have only one variable, so what I'll do, I'll simply print A only. Here also the same. Let me remove all the three. Because all the three variables are having same name. Therefore, that name with that only, I'm trying to print the value. Of course, no. So tell me, internal printf, now this time, first question is, are you going to get any error?
No, sir.
No, sir.
you won't get. This time definitely won't get any error.
We'll get that.
So in case if you are not getting an error, can anybody tell me what is the output you are going to get?
30, 20, 10.
Very good. So here, whenever a global variable and a local variable are having same name with the same data type declared, then always the local variable is given more priority. First preference is given to the local variable. So that's why by keeping in that mind, here the internal printf, when you are trying to print the value of A, there are two A's available for this one. That is 10, 20, 30, all three are available. But which particular A is going to be taken and given?
Immediate local variable, sir.
Immediate local variable. So though having the other two variables with same name, it will give priority to its local variable. So local variable A, which is holding 30, therefore, from internal printf, most internal printf, it will print 30 first. This is what the first printf. Then we come out of this particular variable or sorry, block, and internal A, which is holding 30, this memory is completely destroyed and this A is no more visible. Now to the second printf again, this A, second A, which is holding 20, is local to the WhatsApp block, and this A, which is holding 10, is global to that one. Again, it obeys the same law, same property takes that it will give priority to the local variable. So the local variable A, which is holding 20, that 20 is going to be printed here. And remember, this A is equal to 30, which is there, is no more visible because already I have demonstrated with the different names. So after printing 20, then it will come out of this block. As a result, the two internal A, which are holding A, 20 and 30, are no more visible to the third printer. And for the third printer, the only variable available is what's that A, which is holding 10. So therefore, it will print 10. Thus, the order of output is 30, 20, and 10. As an output, you will get, and you won't get any error. So let us compile this. Yeah, compilation is successful. No errors are there. And if I'm trying to print here, observe carefully, 30, 20, and 10 are what printed on the screen. Okay, that's what about, the variables, automatic type variable properties. Hope that you understand. The same, I think I have taken it as an example, no need to discuss this. Let us go for the second one. Very important, very, very important. And this is what such a keyword which plays very, very important role in object-oriented programming, particularly when we are discussing about Java or C++, the role of static plays a lot, actually. There is so much meaning is there, and so many variables we take, to handle in a good way about the programming, that is what your static variables. So let us discuss about the static variable, okay? Again, we have to discuss about the four properties only directly if you want to talk about the static variable. The scope is limited to the block, means visibility is within the block only as the automatic type variable. As we have seen that already, the automatic type variable, which is local to the cursor block, static variable is also accessed, also visibility is available within the block only. And once if you come out of the block, the visibility is not at all accessed. Okay, that means it's not visible. Second one is default value for the static variable is always zero. That means if you won't store any initial value, previous example, we have taken the three different automatic variables and we provided some values from us. Instead of that, if you won't provide, simply if you declare that variable of static type, then default value is what provided by the compiler and that value is always zero. Okay, and the third one is important one called lifetime. Interesting about the lifetime is, though the visibility is local to the block only, but such a static variables, they retain their memory till the end of program. Okay, they retain their value till the end of the program. The value of the static variable will be destroyed only when you completely stop your program. When the execution of the complete program is over and if you come out of the execution of the program, then only the memory which is allocated to the static variable will be destroyed. So thus, lifetime is throughout the program, but visibility is local to the block. That is what the major difference here that we have to clearly understand. And you can compare with the automatic also. In automatic, lifetime is also local to the block. Scope is local to the block. When it comes to the static here, scope is local, but the lifetime is not local to the block. Rather, okay, it retains its memory, it retains its value till the end of the program. And obviously, the name itself suggests that where the variables of static type are going to be stored. The static data variables are always stored in static memory, that is upon the top of the text memory. Immediately on the top of the text memory, certain fixed amount of memory is going to be allocated. And in that memory, I told you that all the static as well as global variables are going to be stored. So here is the place where static variables are going to be stored, called static memory or data segment, we can also say. And initial value, okay, declaration, we know static keyword we have to use, unlike your automatic type where there is no need to use any keyword. But when it comes to the static storage, explicitly we have to mention with the keyword called static. Static int A or static float, something like that. So here, and you can of course provide some value, or otherwise if you won't provide any value, simply if you keep semicolon, by default it will, the compiler will provide the value which is zero always, initial value. So this is what about the four properties related to static storage. Now this is what that I want to demonstrate. Very interesting. Let me, instead of asking, then let me type the program and I'll ask you about the program. So void main, what I'll do, I'll take two variables, int A is equal to 10, comma B is equal to 20, and both I'm taking them as static type. Static type. Okay, and through printf, I'll try to print the sum of these two, A comma B, A plus B. The sum of these two I want to print. Then I'll increment the A value as well as B also I'll increment. Either you, this way you write the incrementation, or the other way, A is equal to A plus 1, that way also can write. Okay, now what I'll do, this particular body, instead of writing it over here, I'll change this into a some name. I'll give a name to this particular function, stating there something called Stanley. The name of this function is Stanley. Now this Stanley function, through main, I'll call, but while calling, what I'll do, I'll call it multiple times. So for example, 5 times, I want to call the same method called label, Stanley. That's all, no need to pass any arguments, because Stanley is not taking any arguments, not it is returning any value back to the main method. But Stanley is a method which is called 5 times, because within the loop, I'm calling the Stanley method. Now tell me, carefully observe that by keeping the definition of static variable, if you want, I'll revise it. Scope is within the block only. That means wherever the two static variables are declared, within that block only, they can be used. And if you come out of the block, they are not visible to the other blocks, like as your automatic type. But when it comes to the lifetime, it retains its memory till the execution completes. Till the completion of your program, the static variable values will remain like that. Okay, so therefore lifetime is till the end of the program. So these two, by keeping in the mind, no need to talk about the initial values, because here also I provided from my side only the two initial values, 10 and 20. If you won't provide, I told you that they will be taken as 0, 0. Okay. So tell me what the output of this. Yes, Amma.
35 times, sir.
34 times.
Yes, sir.
35 times. Okay.
No, sir. It will increment. No, sir. A and B values are again incrementing.
So tell me what the answer then, if it is the case. You know, only 5 times I'm calling it. Easy to place.
32 A and B, if it is static.
Static is declared, Amma. Both A and B are declared as static. If you are getting confused, I can declare it in next line. Say, I'll keep semicolon here. Static int B. Like this I'll do. Okay? Individually I declared. So
no, sir. Tell me.
One answer I got from some students stating that all the 5 times you will get 30, 30, 30 as an answer.
No, sir.
Ah, tell me what is the answer then.
We'll get incremented, sir. After printing, first we'll print. First it will be printed 30, sir.
Fine.
Then
okay.
afterwards, we'll in the next step, A value will be post incremented. So it will be incremented, but when the situation comes, the value will be updated.
Mm-hmm.
So 30, 32, till 5 times, no, sir. 30, 32, 34, 36, and 38. Like, we'll get incremented on things.
Excellent, Amma. Excellent. That is what that actual lifetime it tells. I agree that A and B, they cannot be used in main because A and B are local variables to the Stanley block. We declared A and B of, though they are static type, but they are declared in Stanley. So they can be used only when you are in Stanley. Usage is within Stanley only. We cannot use A and B in main. Similarly, main is also having a variable called I, which cannot be used in Stanley. Because I is local to the main. So both automatic as well as static variables are visible within their blocks only. But they are differ in lifetime. The static variable lifetime is till the end of the program, they retain their memories, they retain their values which are there in their respective memory which are allotted. So memory retained till the end of the program means the second answer which is given by that girl, 30 is initial output. Second time when we call, we'll have both A and B gets incremented. They become 11 and 21. The sum of the two 11 and 21 are 32. Second time 32. Third time again, that 11 will be incremented to 12 and the 21 will become 22 and the addition will become 34. So like this 30, 32, 34, 36 and 38 are the five times the different answers. See how typical it is actually, the behavior is. Completely typical behavior because it is retaining its value. And we know for any variable, any type of storage class, class variable related, once if a memory is updated, then getting back to the old values is not at all possible, whether they are automatic type or static type, whatever it may be. Here, memories are retained. Initially, A and B are having 10 and 20. But after getting incremented, this 10 and 20 will not be there anymore in the memories because the same memories will not be allocated again. They are allocated once only. And the values of their respective memories can be updated. So that's what I'm doing here. When I updated A with 1, then the 10 will be erased and you'll have 11. So second time when I'm calling, A, the memory which is will not be reinstalled or re-initialized. Memory malli create kaadu. Ade memory vaadukuntundadi. That's our problem here. Okay, therefore, you'll have updated value called 11 only, but it's not possible to get the old value 10. So that's why every time whenever you are calling him, you will get updated values. So let us see the answer here. Let me even keep the new line also to have clear idea. Recompile it. Now we'll run this. Here is that 30, 32, 34, 36, and 38 is what the answers. Because lifetime is the problem. They remain their memories till the execution of the program. And if you come out of the main, okay, gone case. Now what I will do, I will remove this static keyword for both A and B. Tell me what is the output this time you will get. Anyone?
30, sir.
All five times 30?
Because it is automatic, it will it will take as auto and visibility will be ending there itself. So we cannot change the, cannot update the values.
No, visibility does not impact. You know, the visibility is similar to static. I told you the visibility of static as well as automatic are same. That is scope. Scope of both automatic type and static type are same.
They keep lifetime.
They differ at lifetime. If you come up. Yeah, as she said that, the two variables A and B which are declared this time are of automatic type. Am I right? Because we didn't use any keyword. Otherwise, let me use a keyword. No problem. Auto int. Abo also I'll declare it as auto int. So because of A and B are automatic, of course, their memory is going to be immediately created. First time when we are calling Stanley, the control will go to the Stanley block. And in the Stanley block, that A and B are going to be created. The memories related to A and B are going to be created of 4 bytes each because of 32-bit machine or 32-bit compiler. And in that allocated 4 bytes, 10 and 20 are going to be stored. And the sum is displayed, that is 30, fine. After that, we are incrementing A and B. So A will become 11 and B will become 21. But once if you control comes out of this, you know, obviously it has to come out of this because no more instructions are there. And once if the control is coming out of this and back to the main, I gets incremented, it will come 2. And second time when we are calling, before we call the second time, you know, once if the control
modified
is coming,
values will not retain.
First of all, the memories are not at all available, Amma. A and B, which are basically created once if the control is entered into the main or Stanley block, the A and B memories are destroyed. Their lifetime is within the block only. And once we come out of the block, their memory is gone. Not only memory and even values, everything is gone. So erased, no more memory is available because this A and B are allocated where? I told you the difference of allocation is also there. Generally, when we teach in
allocation,
in B level, when we teach, we simply say RAM. But within RAM, the slot for each program, whatever that is going to be allocated, just now we discussed about the memory slot. Static is different, stack is different. So static and declared chesinappudalla variables and static memory, fixed memory lone allocate aitayi and they retain. Andukorke global variables no, static variables no, a compiler design chesavaadu em chesadante, the people those who designed compiler, what they did is, because of they should retain their value, so therefore they should not be in volatilic memory. They should be volatilic means unlike your stack as well as heap memory, they should be fixed memory. And the fixed memory is the bottom, that is what your text memory, above of it static memory. So in static memory, the static type of variables are going to be allocated, they will not be destroyed until the execution completes. But when it comes to the automatic variables here, same A and B, this time they are automatic, therefore these automatic variables are stored in stack memory. And if you come out of the function call, the function related stuff completely erases. Mottham erase aipothundi memory entha nagani enna local variables undani. Assume that function is having multiple memories, let it be. Whatever the number of memories are there, local memories of automatic type within the block, they are all destroyed. Okay, so that's why fluctuation chuincham, no, that's why we have shown the fluctuation in the memory size of stack as well as heap. Heap memory increases or decreases, similarly stack memory also increases and decreases. So as she said that అది ఇంక్రిమెంట్ చేసినా లాభం లేదమ్మా, దో వి హావ్ ఇంక్రిమెంటెడ్ దట్ ఏ అండ్ బి వాల్యూస్ బట్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ వి ఆర్ కమింగ్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ ద బ్లాక్ అండ్ ఇమీడియట్లీ దట్ ఏ అండ్ బి విచ్ ఆర్ అలోకేటెడ్ మెమరీ కంప్లీట్లీ ఇరేజెస్ అండ్ సెకండ్ టైమ్ వెన్ వి ఆర్ కాలింగ్ కంట్రోల్ గో బ్యాక్ టు ద మెయిన్ విత్ స్టాన్లీ మెథడ్ వన్స్ అగైన్ ద ఫ్రెష్ మెమోరీస్ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు బి అలోకేటెడ్ ఫర్ ఏ అండ్ బి అండ్ ద ఫ్రెష్ వాల్యూస్ విచ్ ఆర్ పాస్ట్ 10 అండ్ 20 విల్ బి స్టోర్డ్ ఇన్ దేర్ రెస్పెక్టివ్ అండ్ సెకండ్ టైమ్ ఆల్సో వెన్ వి ఆర్ టైపింగ్ ఇట్ ద సేమ్ 30 ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి ప్రింటెడ్ And even after incrementing the values, there is no use of this increment. We simply come out of this. And once we come out, A and B are destroyed. Same story will be repeated for the remaining 3 times. So you won't get any error, first of all. Fine. But the output is all the 5 times, how much?
30.
Very good. So let me run. See that all 5 times we got 30 only as an answer. That's what the major difference between what, sir? Your static, sorry, automatic as well as static variables. Hope that you understand. Yeah. Now, register type. Third type of this one is what? Register storage class. Register storage class is similar to automatic. Most of the properties are same. Not most of them. All the three, excluding the storage place, all the remaining three properties are remained same like as your automatic. That means what, sir? Register variables can be used within the block only. The lifetime is within the block only. Default value is garbage. All the three are similar to the automatic type. But when it comes to the storage place, where such a register type of variables are going to be stored means the register type of variables are going to be stored in CPU registers. I think that EC people are familiar about this CPU registers and all that. Okay, so registers are small memory or some locations which are very close to CPU, so that CPU can access them very fast compared to the variables which are stored in elsewhere other than registers. So registers are very close to CPU, and on in such a registers only the register storage class variables are going to be stored, but not a rule always, because most of the cases Okay, most of the registers which are close to the CPU, first of all, registers are very less in count. And whatever the registers which are available, they most of them are busy or filled with some other variables or some other CPU related tasks. So these register variables are only allocated, or the register memory is going to be only allocated when the registers are free. Okay, so we say only that the storage place is CPU registers, but not compulsorily that though we declared a variable as a register type, okay, to be always stored in register. Need not. If the registers are not free, then your compiler, what it will do simply, it will treat that as an automatic type variable and it will allocate its memory in a WhatsApp stack memory only. So that's the only difference that we have to remember with respect to register as well as what do you say, automatic type. Because both behave almost same. Now tell me then, what is the use of this storage class means? Generally, for frequently used memories, generally we find it's frequently used variables we generally declare in our program. Such a variables which are most frequently used, that variable generally what we do, we declare them as registers so that they can be accessed, okay, very fast, comparatively automatic type variables. That's the only advantage we have here in this. So most frequently means generally, for example, loop counters. Commonly accessed loop counters. When I said that I is equal to 1, I less than or equal to 10, I plus plus means I very frequently 10 times we are using it. Frequently and the two WhatsApp more number of times we are using it. Such a variables, it is better you declare them as registers. But don't relay that though you have declared it as a register, but not a rule that they should be allotted in the registers only. So no need to explain the remaining things about the register because same properties you will find. If you want, you can execute the same example which we explained it for automatic type. Okay, I can demonstrate them by declaring them as register type. So let us go for the last but not least, the external storage class. The typical behavior we have, the external storage class variables, not only we attach for variables, we can even attach them with the functions also. Similarly, static type variables also, we can declare variables as well as in OOPs like concepts, OOPs like programming languages, static functions also we can create. Come to the external here. External storage class is used when a value is global to the functions. Suppose if you are having multiple functions in your program and you are interested in a common variable which has to be accessed in all the functions, then better declare that as a function as what's a global variable, and generally the global variable is treated as an external. But when we use the keyword external, okay, it is global variable and it is available for some other file also. That is interesting. So by using external keyword, any variable or any function which is declared, such a variable or a function which is declared as an external can be used not only in the same program, in the same file, such a variables or functions can be used in other files also. That is what very important here about the external. And initial value, if you have not initialized any value to this global variables, the global variable values are always initialized to zeros. Okay. Okay, Sarama. So to demonstrate that, what I did is here, I've taken two different files, Amma. Don't feel that they are two or same files. What I did is in one file, I've taken, okay, let me, I think I typed it already, it is there. Through PPT, let me explain first and then we'll go there. So here in this one file contains some external integer variable C which is not defined. Means we have not stored any initial value in it. And a method called write method I have taken which outputs the C value. And this completely I have taken it as header file. I declared this complete one in a separate header file. Then what I did, I completely erased it and went to a separate file. Okay. And a different file I have created in which main method is declared. And in that main method, C is globally defined. Okay. Which is already defined in the other file called external.h. And write function or write method is here externally declared. So, nothing but what I'm trying to say is, one at one place I declared it, other place I'm defining it or I'm using it. and in that main method I'm calling that external return method, write method, and C is initialized here. So when you see the output, you'll get the output properly. That means we can access C here, we can even access the write method. Similarly, write method also, though it is defined in main method with the initial value 5, that can be accessed in the write method. So that means two different files are exchanging their external variables or functions, because they are global. C is a external variable and write is a external function. So this write external function as well as C external variable, both can be accessed, okay, shared between multiple files, because these two are completely different files. One is header file, the other one is my local file. So the same exactly here I'm demonstrating. Okay, so this is what my external header file am. External variable is declared and write method is defined. Similarly, let me take a separate file. This is separate file, my external storage and in this pair. So these are the two different files. External.h is header file. External storage.c is second file. And in this second file, I'm once again declaring that write external is an external method and c is defined locally with 5 as an initial value. So these two can exchange their respective methods as well as variables because they are all global or external. So let me compile. I didn't get any error. Let me even compile the header file also. Here I'm compiling header file. Okay, no errors. It's simply nothing to be done because we don't have any main method and no error is occurred. So once again, I will go for the main method because that is a place from where the execution will start. So I have selected the second file called external storage. And from here, I'll run the program and I got that count is 5. So method is accessed, write external method is accessed, as well as C is also accessed. C is accessed by write method and write method is called by main method. So this is what about the exchanging between the two files. The external variables and functions are shared between the two different files. That is what the importance of your external storage class. Okay, so this is the end of your four different storage classes, Amma. So I will stop here only because actually I prepared some MCQs, but that MCQs in the next class only. I like to demonstrate. Okay, Amma, all of you.
Yes,
I'm stopping it here, Amma. I'm stopping it here. And tomorrow, of course, you have a class because actually today's class is, yesterday's class is postponed to today and I took it. And tomorrow I'm having class again, mostly 6:30 only I'll take the class. And I repeat, first we'll deal with some MCQs because this Sunday we are having the exam in functions, storage classes and pointers. So I prepared some MCQs that we will discuss it in the class, and if time permits, we'll start arrays. But all of you, all the 80 or 90, whatever the number of members are there in skill development program, don't miss the classes which are related to arrays. I want to stress some more on that. Okay, few typical programs also we'll try to solve by using arrays. And as part of arrays,